Hello, everybody. Welcome back. This is Orange Gillen and Hello, everybody. This is Orange Gillen, and today I am back for some more Fairy Tale. There's going to be episodes 11 and 12 of the final series. I almost said final season, which isn't exactly untrue. So last time they've reached Alvarez and Zaref. Frickin' Zaref is Emperor Spriggan. So apparently he's going to start a, well, we would call it war. He calls it an extermination. So that's always a bucket of joys for everybody involved. So Mess just rescued Makarov, and they need to get out of there. And from the next time, apparently they're going to be attacked by the guy with the sand, or the desert person. And since they're in sort of a desert, it's going to be sort of his home field advantage. Yeah, the only other thing that I have is that I think I finally cracked the code for the new iMovie. If you've been following along, you know I've had issues where like things have become desynced over it. I finally figured out what fixes that, and it is actually my Ruby reactions that did that, because I just take a video of the screen, and QuickTime was what I used to do that. I just take a screen recording, and QuickTime records it in 60 frames a second. And when I did a little syncing thing, it actually matched up for once. So in the previous Fairy Tale, I changed the frame rate of the video to 60 frames, and it stayed in sync. So I think I figured it out. So it makes editing these a little less irritating. It makes iMovie a little less irritating. Yay. Speaking of editing, this is only going to be a two-parter because I have stuff I need to do. This week, I'm recording this on the 18th, so I have stuff I needed to do this past week, so I didn't have as much time to edit and record stuff, or maybe record stuff, but I don't know, maybe I'll do, I'm planning on doing a bunch of two-parters just so that I have a little bit more time over the week to edit stuff, because the last couple of times has been like long stuff, and hopefully I could upload some other things, like re-upload my Konosuba and Saga of Tanya the Evil reactions, either in redirect or actually YouTube. I don't think it's going to be on actual YouTube because it hasn't in the past. Strangely enough, though, the first episode of Saga of Tanya Evil, which I recorded on my previous channel for my 3,000 subscriber, actually didn't get blocked at all, so people actually managed to watch that, which is interesting in my opinion. Same thing with the Fairy Tale movies. They still haven't been blocked, and it's a freaking movie. And my Fairy Tale reactions are still not getting blocked, or only partially blocked, which I'm hoping that stays for the rest of the series. Nervous laughter. And once again, I'm not wearing my earbuds or headphones because I just don't want to deal with that right now. All right. So let's watch episode 11.
You hideous soul! You demon!
Close, old man. But the meaning of the name Spriggan is much more akin to hideous fairy.
It's Gramps!
Hey, Gramps!
My children are here.
Guys, I saw Zaref. He was with Zaref.
Are you sure?
Natsu, after all this time, you have come.
Zaref is here? Like, on this continent?
I can hardly believe it myself. But this Empire's leader, who they call Spriggan, is actually the Black Wizard Zaref.
How is that possible?
Since you've come all
this way,
how
they're still in swimsuits.
I assume Mest has filled you in on the situation and what I was trying to accomplish by traveling here.
He has.
I'm just so happy that you're okay.
I've been far too naive through this whole ordeal. I came here believing that they would be willing to negotiate, but that was just a fantasy. And before I made the journey west,
it's been a while since I heard this.
I put the future of the guild in jeopardy. All that heartache and pain was for nothing.
This year was tough. Well, we all made our way through it, and we're even stronger.
It really is true. And the bond we share could never be
broken.
Let's go.
Let's get away from here.
We found each other again.
If concern for another is what pushes you to act, then it means something. Showing you care is important. Master, you taught us that lesson.
This is the reverse of
Let's go home.
When Makarov found Natsu.
Fairy tale's waiting.
His beard is very absorbent.
I'm ready.
Making jokes. To the godforsaken land.
We have a lot of catching up to do, but first we should get out of this place.
Yeah, you're right.
And meanwhile,
do I know
this
I used too many direct lines in a row, so I'm running low on magic power. I only have enough to teleport us one more time. I think it would be best to use that last teleport to reach Serrano's ship. So we'll need to travel a bit on land.
Serrano, that's how you pronounce it. I've always thought of it as Sorno.
And after we were getting to know each other.
I have a farewell gift for you. I'd like you to have it before you take a long nap in the ground.
No, a shield.
Impossible. How did he find us?
Sand. Sand is nice. It tells me almost everything.
And meanwhile,
this
Anakin
guy's
is
got as much magic power
having
as
a seizure.
The girl on Caracol Island.
Just melt the sand.
You mustn't fight him. He's much too powerful. We should run.
For real? Our master clearly gave the order to retreat.
But Urza,
let's go now.
We already have a magic mobile ready and waiting.
Huh? Come on, get in.
Can't we walk? I'll drive us. SC plug connected.
So those are Makarov's lackeys.
It's like a
this'll be
Juvia's
fun.
Water body. And
this sucks. Sure does.
Can we go faster?
I'm trying.
Look through the veins.
He's coming.
What is that thing?
Sandstorm? Oh. Okay.
Whoa. It's a giant sand monster.
Not good.
It's gaining on us. You and I need to try to stop it, Lucy.
Right.
So
how's
sick.
I wonder how Scorpio's gonna fail.
Sorry for squishing you, Natsu.
No, don't! He's too powerful for us to fight!
Yeah, well, I'm not sure about that, Gramps.
Star dress! Sagittarius!
Hey!
Form.
There's so much magic power coming from those two. They told me they'd gotten stronger. But to have grown so much in only a year is incredible.
Let's show them what we got.
So you're actually gonna put up a fight, are ya?
Ice makes silver.
Looks like Gray froze everything with that attack. Impressive.
Ice makes
nice.
Silver. All right.
Creatures are coming for us.
I'll take care of them. Star shot.
Ooh. I like that star shot.
This is even more fun than I thought it would be.
He's gone!
Beneath us, he merged with the sand. Watch for an attack.
Huh?
Antlion pit!
What's happening?
Damn it!
Man, that was pathetic. You guys should have stayed back in Ishgar, because you're really in over your heads here.
Everyone, out of the car! Hurry!
The hell?
It's actually pulling us down.
I can't move my legs anymore.
I can't count how many people I've killed with this.
Entire cities have been swallowed up whole inside it.
Great.
My antlion trap is like a gateway to hell. Nobody has ever escaped from it.
It's like, well, they've
Before
gone through
you
hell.
Go to your graves thinking Tartarus. That you're something special. You should know this. You're just a bunch of losers, like all of the other wizards we've killed over the years. We're on a different level altogether than you maggots from Ishgar. The gods have abandoned your whole freaking continent. It'll be so easy for Alvarez to take it over. Sucks to be you guys. Oh man, the looks on your faces are priceless.
Yep.
So the gods abandoned Ishgar, huh? That's not a problem. Because Fairy Tail is still watching over it.
He made my sand evaporate?
It's like, you know, let's take him out now.
It's been forever since somebody got in a solid punch like that. Yeah, bring it on!
It's... How many against one?
Cool it down!
All dried up.
What's he doing?
This again?
You won't hurt my children!
Whoa!
As long as I draw breath, I'll protect my family at any cost!
Come on, Gramps, let us go so we can follow this guy!
Would you please stop yelling?
Is that so? Well, you won't be drawing breath for that much longer. If you think you can protect them, you don't understand the power of the Spriggan 12.
Oh. Oh, no, wait.
We'll die together.
That's his magic.
Drowning
I thought it was a whole
in my sands
army.
Of death.
Now, Mest, teleport us!
Where can we go?
Away? Up?
I will keep you safe if it's the last thing I do.
Here it comes! And every single thing that gets caught in the path of this sandstorm shrivels up and dies instantly!
Gramps, no! Master!
Run!
Get out of here!
You're gonna be a bunch of fairy mummies in just a second.
Is that Loxus? Ah.
That sandstorm was completely obliterated with only one shot.
He's always been flashy like that.
It's amazing!
Sounds like him.
Hey, old man. You're
he looks
older.
Different.
We're behind
looks
enemy
a little bit
lines,
more well groomed.
So we gotta get out of here ASAP. Thank this guy for the ship.
Yeah, Godzilla hasn't had motion sickness.
Lily up there too. Hold on just a second. How are you and Loxus not puking your guts out?
Gray, my darling, don't worry, I'm here too!
Hey,
that's the question
I
was just asking.
Manly.
How is that gonna help? The ship's been modified so dragon slayers can ride on it and not get sick!
There is the answer.
Hey, Wendy, you've really grown up since last time we met.
She's everybody
gone
says
little
that.
Girl to little lady.
Seems like everybody's changed from last year.
Oh, yeah? I don't think I've changed all that much, actually.
You're down there too, right, Mest? Teleport onto the ship if you're able!
Coming up! Ugh, you can't run from me!
No one's running. We're just flying back home, okay? And I'm gonna get cranky if we miss dinner.
God damn!
That was intense. They must be taking this seriously. I guess you put up that barrier
oh, that's August.
Kind of favor to me.
Even an old man like me finds it painful to lose a comrade in battle.
So you think that little light show would have killed me? Sorry, August. You must be getting senile.
It begins, Natsu. Game on.
What do you think about our manly rescue?
You're safe now.
Gotta say I'm surprised to see you here.
We knew the master was in trouble, so we came up with a rescue plan. Luckily, we got Loxus to help out.
You got some nerve leaving without us.
Well, it was a covert operation.
Being on a ship is awesome when you don't need to hurl the whole time. What do you say you and me fight to celebrate?
I'll pass.
Back at the guild.
My children. It feels so good to be with my fairy tale family again.
Hey,
let's have a toast.
We did the
fairy
guild.
Fairy tale is back in business.
Hall.
Welcome back, master.
Hang on. If Urza's our master now, then what in the heck are we supposed to call him?
Mr. Makarov, I suppose?
I don't know. Doesn't feel quite right to me. Call him master, because I'll be stepping down.
No, sweet little Oscar.
Now he's the ninth again.
I'm confused. Does this make him our eighth master?
Can't believe this is the third time. I mean, how does he keep getting revived like that?
It's not like he died. Looks like I'll be guildmaster till I die this time around.
Now that's a man's dedication.
I believe that's what you said the last time this happened.
All right, let's crack open the booze and get this shindig started.
It's time to party!
I'm kind of surprised you guys decided to join Blue Pegasus.
There are worse jobs than serving customers.
Yeah, but I feel way more at home in a rowdy bar like this.
I do have to ask how Loxus fit in at that guild. I mean, did he actually do the hospitality part of the job?
He did once in a while. I can't say it was very hospitable.
What happens at the guild hall stays in the guild hall.
Did you manage to get in contact with Serrano after we left that place?
Yeah, I did. And she was not a happy camper.
I heard the news. You're the most recent member of the Motion Sickness Club.
Yeah. Don't let it get you down, Wendy. I've always been that way.
I don't see how that's supposed to make her feel any better.
Looking for a fight?
Motion Sickness Club.
How did that little exchange turn into a fight?
I'll never run They're always ready. Again.
If it's that big of a deal for you.
Oh, Gray. Please. I want to know what your hospitality is like.
What the hell do you mean?
Man, did I miss you guys.
The guild hall's just as noisy as I remember it.
If you ask me, it sounds like things are finally getting back to normal.
Well, for how long? That's the next question, especially if Alvarez.
We were able to get our beloved master back to Fairy Tale, and Loxus and the Thunder Legion to boot. But during our journey, we found out that the Alvarez Empire on the Western Continent has wizards more powerful than any we've faced before. But what's even scarier is that the Black Wizard Zarif rules over that empire. And not only that, he's planning on coming to Ishgar to take the Lumen Histoire, our guild's biggest treasure, the crystal that contains the body of our first master. There's gonna be a war for sure, and I'm positive it's gonna be the most grueling battle we've been through. I don't even want to think about losing anything.
That actually looks good.
There has to be a way we can get through this in one piece. I just want the feeling we share here to last forever. To live inside this moment. That's my deepest wish.
Who's that? Oh. I thought it was somebody that came into the guild
hall. Children, let me apologize. I'm not going to make any excuses for myself. I took your home and your way of life away from you. That was a mistake on my part.
Don't worry, Mess explained it all.
You followed the only course of action you believed you had to protect us.
We understand your feelings.
And anyway, the guild's back together now, so everything's fine.
That's why I say we should have a little more booze and a little less boo-hoos.
This is serious. Because I wasn't able to negotiate for our safety, there's no doubt Alvarez will invade. They are a true superpower, and they will throw everything they have at us.
So what? I'm ready! Time and time again, we've put everything on the line for the sake of the guild. No matter how tough our enemies may be, we fight for what's most important to us. That's what makes us so strong.
I forgot Woody cut her hair for that.
It's not that I'm not scared, but no matter how I feel, I can't let go of my responsibility. Plus, I know I can count on everybody else. What I'm most afraid of is losing what we all have together. So we can't run away from this. We have to fight for our family and for the bond we share. We gotta make a stand.
You burned my map.
And it's not just about winning. This time our fight is about living.
I think everyone's made up their minds, old man.
As have I. Listen up. We are going to make them rue the day they chose to mess with our family. Let's take them down!
I'm all fired up now!
We're gonna have to give it everything we've got.
Well, don't we always?
This foe's like none we've ever faced.
We'll be fighting Xerath.
I'm gonna find E&D.
We'll make it through this fight just like all the others.
Get my claws into those big magic meaties from Alvarez!
I'll protect the guild this time. I swear I will.
After training for the last year, I'm ready to show off the new skills I picked up.
Whoa, you've actually been training for this entire year?
Oh yeah, she's like way stronger now, and I am too.
Oh man, did I miss this frickin' guild or what?
The new guild hall looks definitely better inside.
Before we get too carried away, there's some extremely important information I must share with you. It's concerning the Lumen Histoire, or rather what's formerly referred to as the Fairy Heart.
I think perhaps I should be the one to explain this to them. Eighth Master.
Third, sixth, eighth.
Is this a projection of her? Or is she really here?
It's likely. You've not heard of Fairy Heart. For many years, it's been our guild's most closely guarded secret. For good reason. Because the world must never learn exactly what it holds. However, I believe it's crucial that you know why Xerath would go to such lengths to get it. And also, about my own sin.
You're sure?
I am. It's time for my long-held secrets to be revealed.
Huh.
This is a tale of a boy and girl, of the awful curse they shared, and the primordial magic
shared
that they sought together.
Shared. Huh. So, is Mavis sealed away in the crystal to prevent the sin? Curious. Curiouser and curiouser. Yeah. So that's something that happened. Alright, so that was episode... What episode did I just watch? 11, right? Yeah, that was episode 11. Let's move on to episode 12. We'll get some answers. I always am a sucker for expository, well, not expository, but like backstory episodes. One of my favorite episodes is episode or chapter 3 of Ruby volume 6, the whole backstory between Salem and Ozpin. And I don't know what it is. It's like those stories where, well, rather than just exposition told to us, it's tone told and shown. Like, it's made into a story rather than just kind of spouted out. That's one of the reasons why I like it, is because it's like storytelling almost. So that's why I'm always eager for these kind of episodes. All right, let's go.
It's likely you've not heard of Fairy Heart. For many years, it's been our guild's most closely guarded secret. For good reason. Because the world must never learn exactly what it holds. However, I believe it's crucial that you know why Xerath would go to such lengths to get it. And also, about my own sin. It's time for my long-held secrets to be revealed. This is a tale of a boy and girl, of the awful curse they shared, and the primordial...
It's also strange that they're sitting next to each other like that. Because... In Fairy Tale Zero, that we had these always at a distance.
over 100 years ago, not long before Fairy Tale was founded. We crossed paths in a forest west of Magnolia, where both our fates were forever changed. He was stricken by the curse of Ankh-Selim. Against his will, this horrible curse killed every living thing around him. I found him to be completely fascinating. He taught me so much about the world of magic. At the time, Magnolia was controlled by a dark guild called Blue Skull. They treated the citizens with such cruelty. So my friends and
I... Yeah, someone said that she used, not fairy law, but just law. Which is why she got...
I cast an unperfected black magic spell that brought us victory. Because I wasn't ready to wield that spell, there was an unintended consequence. My body would cease growing. In April of 686, we founded Fairy Tale.
Oh, wait, no. I already knew that.
Trade disputes between feudal lords had been escalating at an alarming pace. And later that year, the bloody Second Trade War began tearing the kingdom apart.
Mavis and Xerath.
Pull back, please.
What? Little girl, are you insane? They're within striking distance of the enemy's weakest point. Now is the time to attack. Look, you may be a wizard, but you are out of your league here on the battlefield.
That's why I'm not on the battlefield. I'm the strategist.
If I were the enemy, I would set up a small ambush squad near this hill, then lure in the opposition and lose that squad upon them. At the same time, I'd send reinforcements west to attack our main battalion here. I can formulate 49 effective countermeasures at the moment. But first, we need to pull back that left flank. They'll join the battalion in an echelon formation, and then we all watch for the enemy's next maneuver.
Look at the princess bossing him around.
I'd argue she's more like a general than a princess.
Seriously, you'd never guess she was a military genius.
Are you ready?
So, is our wizard squad gonna get the chance to join in the action?
I'll need you to keep the enemy's wizard squads at bay. And it's very likely they'll be getting backup from the west. Be careful.
Let's go tear it up, you guys!
Ready to show what we can do!
Prex already in the dark armor.
I have faith in you.
Hold on a second. Is that Fairy Tale's Munchkin Master? I think she's a real fairy.
Is there a storm coming?
What
nope.
The? An enemy wizard! What guild is he from?
Fairy Tale says hello. Boom! And with that, my score goes up to 27.
Still behind me, Yuri? I've already taken out 34 and counting.
I'm at 100 and something. Ha! I'm just kidding with you, fellas.
Oh, he just said, I just realized what he said. I'm just kidding with you, fellas.
They came in way outnumbered, but somehow still managed to win easily. That girl.
Quality over quantity.
Fairy tactician.
Woo! We did it, you guys! Look at all this gold! Now this calls for good wine.
Cheers!
You look kind of glum. Something wrong?
I was thinking about the battle today. It's mind-boggling how many lives must have been lost.
For some reason, I just got a desire to tickle those feet.
This war is brutal. How long do you suppose until it's all over? I just want to go on another adventure. The Second Trade War finally came to an end in the year 690. While the ceasefire was a welcome development, the resulting casualties were over 10 times that of the First Trade War. Most people believe the high rate of mortality was due to the Wizard Guild's involvement in the fighting. As a result, the Wizarding World came together and the Interguild Conflict Ban Treaty was signed.
That's why the Council.
This monumental
agreement
brought about a brief period of peace in the land.
That's why, okay.
A few years later, I had another chance encounter with him while walking through the forest.
Is that you, Mavis?
Oh my gosh, it's so good to see you again! Yay!
Wait, stay back! You shouldn't get close to me! I'm cursed, remember?
I know!
What are you...
I want to thank
it's like all the medieval romance stories. Magnolia, everything happens in the forest. Help.
We saved the town with what you taught us. Hold on a minute. You're actually the Black Wizard Seraph? For real?
That's why I didn't want to tell you my name back then.
I've heard that you've been alive for over 300 years. Is that true?
It is. Wow. I rarely think about how long it's been.
I must say, you're nothing like the rumors paint you out to be.
Well, what do they say about me? The bad stuff's likely true for the most part.
Why would you say something like that? Huh? I mean, your eyes have such a kind and gentle quality to them. I refuse to believe there's a bad person in there.
You only say that because you're so innocent.
Do you remember Yuri, that hot-blooded friend of mine? Well, he and his wife are about to have their first child.
But he's practically still a child himself.
You do realize it has been 10 years since you've seen him.
I suppose I'd forgotten, considering how little you've changed since then.
Oh, because I still look the same. You're right. I guess that is confusing. I should tell you that to win the battle, I cast an incomplete black magic spell. But it was the only way I could save my friends. So it was worth it in the end.
Don't tell me you used the law spell!
Whoa! What's this about all of a sudden? hey. Something wrong?
You haven't just stopped growing, Mavis. You've become like me. You won't ever grow old or die.
What?
You made a judgment on who lives and dies. That's the purpose of the spell.
So she can't die either?
Now you have the curse of Onxellum, which means the more value that you place on life, the more death will follow you.
That's not true.
Doesn't seem right.
That hasn't happened. Nobody just dies around me. So it can't be.
Perhaps that's the case for the time being. But think about this. That war that went on must have affected you. War tends to dull a person's feelings concerning life and death. I can imagine that your thoughts on all of it are still in a state of flux.
Oh god, that's scary.
Because I...
I hate to say it, but I'm afraid that you've yet to realize the true value of life. And the moment you discover what that is, the people closest to you will start to die.
I'm not... I guess it's true, but I'm not buying it.
Such things. It's cruel.
It would be much more cruel to lie to you.
Don't you have feelings?
You said you didn't believe the rumors about me, but I'd wager you've changed your mind.
Because... I mean, yeah, the true intent is the same, but definitely not the end result.
Alongside me.
Or the ultimate goal, because Zeraph is trying to bring back the dead. Mavis was trying to, well, not bring back the dead, but keep people, someone
He's
from dying.
Liar. How dare he say that to me? I do know the value of life. It's more important than anything.
Congrats, Yuri, you're a father now.
Whoa!
What he said isn't true! In March of 696, Yuri's only son, Makarov, was born.
A healthy baby boy.
I'm so proud of you.
Mavis.
I love you.
Wow! Cute!
I forgot her hair thingies did that.
Deliver him inside the guild hall. What could I say? Rita insisted on it.
There's love here. I want my child to feel that from everyone in the guild. It's the most important thing there is.
You're right about that.
Master Mavis, if you don't mind, could you do the honor of naming him for us?
What? Wait, you mean me?
That would be a priceless gift.
I think that you should name the boy Pipoko.
For the baby's sake, I don't think you should leave it up to us.
Yeah.
Makarov. I read a story about a kind-hearted king, and that was his name. Makarov, huh? It's nice. I like it.
Hey, Makarov.
Yeah, okay.
It's awesome! The kind-hearted boy Makarov.
He's the first of the next generation. He is. The bond we share is special. Promise me that we'll...
Rita! Hey! What's wrong?
Having the baby must have taken too much out of her.
I hate to say it, but I'm afraid that you've yet to realize the true value of life. And the moment you discover what that is...
My God! Rita! Please stay with me! Rita!
Oh, fuck.
The people closest to you will start to die.
Withers trees and kills animals, and of course, takes the lives of people.
I'm upset now. I am seriously upset.
I never returned to the guild hall again. I aimlessly wandered the land, leaving countless corpses in my wake. After a year had passed,
there you are, Mavis. I've searched for you.
Oh, it's you.
You're not looking too good.
I haven't had anything to eat or drink in over half a year, but here I am. I want it all to be over.
That's one of the things about the curse of Anxellum. You could go so far as to cut off your own head and you still wouldn't die.
Please, Seraph. I need your help. I'm begging you to kill me!
Sorry, but what you're asking is impossible. There's nothing in the world that can kill either one of us. At first, I felt exactly...
How about each other?
Honestly, I still think about what a relief death would bring all the time. But regardless, you need to try and change your perspective on the matter. We both have an eternity here to do other things.
Come to the dark side.
As for me, I've created a new kind of beast I call Aetherius. My hope is that one day their inhuman strength can end my life of suffering. And I've spent some time building a country.
A country?
It's a small place on the western continent now. But we're growing rapidly, because people will do things for me. It's a fun little challenge. In fact, I'm known as Emperor Spriggan over there. I view my subjects as mere pawns. Don't judge. It's safer that way. With that attitude, the curse of Anxellum won't affect them at all.
Okay, that explains it. It's like an intricate
simulation game.
What are you trying to do?
She looks like Tinkerbell almost.
A war? But don't get the wrong idea. I detest conflict. In fact, I think it's absolutely revolting. Me building this empire is just a way to pass the time, but it disgusts me.
Huh? But you just said it was a fun challenge.
Did I? I don't remember.
Are all his thoughts contradictions too?
My entire life is wrapped up in this game now. I only live so I can die. Or to get my little brother back. Maybe just so I can kill him. Or is it so my little brother can kill me? Alvis, it makes my head feel like it's on fire.
Shit, it affects thoughts too.
Seraph.
The world hates me. It continually rejects me. Everything hurts.
I won't reject you, Seraph. I accept who you are. I may be the only one, but I understand how you feel. You can't give up. I know we'll find a way to lift the curse someday. Together. Just you and I.
Do you mean that?
Yes.
Oh, Mavis. This is the first time anyone's ever been truly kind to me.
Come on. You've probably forgotten what it's like, that's all.
I know that I've never felt this way about anybody before.
The abyss of sorcery, where everything begins. It contains the primordial essence of magic, love. Love brings about miracles, and oftentimes tragedies. The two who carried the curse of contradiction shared their love, and the result was yet another contradiction. The more love you have, the more life this curse takes. Such a bitter contradiction is what took my immortal life.
Skipping.
Mavis and Seraph created their own miracle. It would evolve into an incredibly powerful form of magic that must remain hidden to the world. The family she built is determined to cheer her up. To help her let go of the shame she feels, we share our love with her. Meanwhile, across the deep blue ocean, the Alvarez Empire continues with their plan, steadily preparing for an assault on Ishgar. Next time, Fairy Heart. The deep bond we have with each other is our constant source of strength.
Well, we got half the answers. I guess the other half is coming next time. Sorry to make you guys wait. Hi. So I guess it's true that Mavis also has a curse of contradiction now, but my reasoning is that it's not the same thing as Zeros, or doesn't warrant the same punishment, you could say. True, yeah. I mean, like, she was trying to save somebody, but he wasn't technically dead, and she was trying to protect somebody from, like, the orb thing, whatever that was, the Tinro orb, and is it only black magic that causes that? Because she said it was the black magic, and then she hasn't learned it yet, or hadn't fully learned law yet, but is that what caused her to be cursed? Because it does, the math doesn't add up, in my opinion. But obviously, it got the same result. It ended up, it's like getting 2 plus 2 and you're getting X. And it's not one of those Sulfur X sort of things.
I'm adding this in after editing and rewatching this scene, and I think I get it a little bit more when Xerath explains law. Basically, it's the judgment on who lives and who dies. And I'm guessing because Mavis hadn't fully learned the spell, that she got the Curse of Contradiction. So it's similar to how Xerath got his, but only if you squint and you don't have glasses on. Basically, it's at a stupid basic level, it's the same desire to break the laws of life and death, but I still think the punishment doesn't match the action. And there wasn't any evidence that Yuri was dead or was going to die, just that he was possessed by the Tenru Orb. Xerath's explanation makes sense, but like I said, I don't think the punishment matches the action. Alright, back to the reaction.
And then we also see that Xerath's thoughts are now contradictory as well. Not just his love for life, it's his own thoughts that are contradictory. So that definitely screws it up. I guess that's why his demons, Aetherius, are all messed up as well, because like, if you don't want to see yourself as the villain, don't make demons that go around killing everything. I don't know why I'm doing the head thing. Yeah, so next time we're going to see how she gets inside of the big old crystal and forms the fairy heart. Shit, man. I'm upset now. About that whole thing. Okay, well, alright. So, I hope you enjoyed that, or watching me suffer through that. So, yeah. It isn't... Okay, so Ankh-Selim is the god of life and death, apparently, I think. Right? Is that what he is? He's a pretty shitty god, in my opinion. And I think a lot of people's opinions. It's like, you look at the big picture, you dingus. Doesn't deserve to be cursed. Xerath deserves to be cursed because he's trying to bring him back somebody, but Mavis didn't deserve to be cursed because she was trying to save somebody that was still alive, just possessed by an evil thing, and cast an unfinished spell, or an unlearned spell. Ah! Alright. So, this has been episodes 11 and 12 of Fairy Tail. Like, leave a comment. I expect a lot of comments. And subscribe. Hit the notification for more Fairy Tail, more Ruby, and whatever comes out next. It's been a while since I finished with that. This has been Orange Gun, and I will see you all later.
I don't like sand.
Sand is nice. I hate you!
Children, let me apologize. I'm not going to make any excuses for myself. I took your home and your way of life away from you.
I also took all your faces somehow.